brothers and sisters, Brother Patrick. It's my video about being baptized in the Holy Spirit. Listen to me. People will say, just like healing, it's like salvation, healing, baptism, Holy Spirit, all these things is by faith, okay? The Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God. And He's a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Listen, Jesus said, seek and you shall find. Ask and it'll be given to you. Knock and it'll be open. There in Luke chapter 11, He says, you being evil know how to give good gifts to your children. How much more does the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? And just in the verse before that, He's talking, He says, you know, who asks his father for a fish and he gives him a snake? See? He goes on about that. So in other words, God's not going to give you a demon. He's going to give you His Holy Spirit. When you experience God's Holy Spirit, you'll know it's His Holy Spirit. Okay? If you're already born again, you already know a little bit about the Word of God and you know who's Jesus. Because the Holy Spirit bears witness that Jesus Christ is the Lord, the only Lord and the only begotten Son of the Father. So, don't be afraid. Lots of people, like myself, I'll tell the truth, I was kind of afraid of the Holy Spirit, you know, but I was seeking it, and I knew that's what I wanted, but I was kind of afraid of God. I can't lie to you, but I think it's natural to be. The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of all wisdom, so I was afraid of the Lord, so it's only natural to be afraid, okay? But once you're born again, you're a candidate to receive the Holy Spirit. Cornelius and those guys, they received it immediately when Peter was giving them the gospel. While he was telling them about Jesus and all that, the Holy Spirit fell and they all spoke in tongues. Cornelius in Acts chapter 10 and 11. So, there's no waiting period. There's no other requirements to just be born again. And then you're eligible to receive. Listen, when you got saved, Jesus didn't get back on the cross. He did it once. He gave salvation. He died on the cross. Was resurrected after the third day. Therefore, He already did the work. He died on the cross for our sins. A one-time deal. Okay, the Holy Spirit was given one time on the day of Pentecost. God doesn't give you the Holy Spirit. He already gave it. You see what I'm saying? The difference, it's a subtle difference. He didn't give you salvation. He gave it to the world. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him will not perish but have everlasting life. God gave His Son, and it's a done deal. Jesus said it's finished. The Holy Spirit came on Pentecost, okay? And people received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And so now you would receive that. In Acts chapter 2, Peter said that this gift is for you, your children, and your children's children, and as many who are fall off, as many as our Lord our God would call. Acts chapter 2, verse 37. So we can all receive the Holy Spirit. All through the book of Acts, I just made another video. If you didn't watch my other video, the one I made right before this, I don't know what I'm going to call it yet. I just started uploading it. But the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Okay, this is, I'm getting ready to pray for you. I'm just trying to get your faith right. You have to have faith to receive. Just like when you got saved, you believed that Jesus died on the cross for you. You believed it. You prayed, Jesus, you know, forgive me my sins, come into my heart. I know you're down on the cross. Whatever you prayed, like along those lines. You became born again. Okay? So this is for those who are already born again. And Peter said, this is that which was spoken of by the prophet Joel, that in the last days, says the Lord, I'll pour out my Spirit on all flesh. My son, your sons and daughters will prophesy. And old men will dream dreams and young men will have visions. Okay, this is that. This is that. That Holy Spirit. The Greek word is dunamis, dynamite. Where we get the English word dynamite comes from dunamis. Power. As Jesus told the apostles before He ascended into heaven, you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you. All of us need the power of God in our life. The enemy has used these old Pharisee denominational people to block the laity, as I mentioned in my last video, what they call the laity, Nicolaitan, that Jesus hates the works of the Nicolaitans, Revelation 2 and 3. That's victory over the laity. They try to subdue the people and make themselves as a god and some kind of overlords. That's what like the Catholic Church and then lots of these old Protestant denominations are the same way. They try to keep God's people down and control God's people. Look, the Bible says that we're all kings and priests unto our Lord and our God. We're all called to minister unto the Lord. Okay? Inside here is the temple of God. Not some church building. That's why they keep, you know, in the church, they'll call the church a sanctuary. Right here. I'm a born-again Christian. The sanctuary of God is right here. And then we as a body, we are the sanctuary. We are the church. Not a building. The ecclesia is the called out ones. That Greek word for church. So they put church in the Bible in our modern translations, church, it means called out ones, separated ones. That's us, not any kind of a building. We're the sanctuary, not some place. Anywhere I go, the church is there. Jesus said, where two or more of you are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of you. That's the church. Where we go together and meet and pray, hey, that's the church. It's not a building. It's not up to some, you know, some guy, you know, as a pastor or whatever, PhD of theology or whatever. But God did, and I always put this disclaimer in my videos, God did call pastors, prophets, evangelists, teachers, and apostles to be leaders in his church, to bring us, to, you know, to be overseers. So what the real Greek word is there is episkopalia, which means overseer. So there are overseers, like myself, in the ministry that I'm in. I'm an overseer in the body of Christ, but I'm not. There's only one shepherd, that's Jesus Christ, you know. He's the only shepherd. So pastors are assistants to the good shepherd, but they're not the shepherd. They're only supposed to be leading you to Christ. They're leading you to Jesus, not anywhere else. And then Jesus is the one, as John the Baptist said, baptized with the Holy Spirit and with fire. So if you want to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you receive it just like you did salvation. It's by faith. It's by faith. I'm going to pray for you right now to receive the Holy Spirit. And you have to say this like the one with the issue of blood who touched the hem of Jesus' garment. And almost all the Gospels, it said, she said within herself, if I can only touch the hem of his garment, I'm going to be healed. And what did she do? She said it. She acted on it. She reached out. You know, she could have said it and then just sat there looking blank. No, she crawled on the ground. She acted on the word she said. If I can touch him his garment, I'm going to be healed. She acted on it. She touched his garment. She was healed. And Jesus turned to her and said, daughter, be of good cheer. Thy faith has healed you. Thy faith has healed you. The power of God to heal is always there. It was always there. Jesus said, I felt virtue go out of me. My power went out of me. The power for heal was for everybody. But she said within herself, she made a statement of faith, if I touch the hem of Jesus' garment, I'm going to be healed. She acted on it. She did it. It's just like the light switch of this, you know, my room here. I mean, the electricity's there, but if I don't turn on the light switch, there's no light. But it's there. I just have to go over there, flip it on. It's like the key to your car. I could sit here and hold the keys in my car and say, this key, if I went outside and stuck this in the ignition and turned the key, it's going to start the car. But I just kept sitting here. The car's not going to start. I have to act on that. So you make a statement of faith. I know that if I pray and believe, ask the Lord, then tell the Lord I receive the baptism of His Holy Spirit, I will. You confess that, but then you don't do it. It ain't going to happen. It's just like when you get out of the bed. You know, unless you're handicapped, you know by faith that when you hit the ground, your feet's going to hold you up. You don't sit there and think, oh Lord, please let my feet work when I hit the ground. You don't do that because you know by faith that when you hit the ground, your feet's going to work. You don't even think about it. It's just, hey, it's just it's like salvation. You don't have to keep thinking about it every 5 minutes. You know, if you're born again, you're born again. And you're walking in the will of God. You're walking with Jesus. Amos chapter 3:3. How can two walk together except they be in agreement? You're walking with Christ. Second nature. I mean, it's part of your life. It's just like getting up and walking. You know, when you're a baby, yeah, you were afraid. But once you started walking, hey, unless you get, you know, become injured or backslidden, right? I mean, there's no, you're walking. Anyway, let me pray with you because I keep making my videos so long, brothers and sisters. I'm going to pray right now for you to receive the Holy Spirit. I want you to come in agreement with me right now that when we pray, you will receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. Just begin to praise the Lord. Just begin to praise Him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Whatever. And just relax because you will do the talking. The Bible says that they began to speak with tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. So you are the one talking, but the Holy Spirit is the one giving you the utterance. Just relax. Don't worry about it. Don't try to do anything. Just keep praising the Lord. And just by faith receive it. And just pray until you receive it. And I'm going to start you right now and pray with you for a minute. After that, you just, if you have to, go put on some worship music. A real good anointed worship music and play it. You can find it lots of stuff on YouTube and play it and just keep praising the Lord and believe that you receive it in Jesus' name. I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord God, right now, Lord, you gave us the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost. And right now, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, I release the Holy Spirit. And I declare, Lord, what you said through John the Baptist, that you, Lord Jesus, baptized with the Holy Spirit with fire. And right now, I release the baptism of the Holy Spirit, Lord, that you gave upon your people right now in the name of Jesus. And I command them in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach to receive a baptism of the Holy Spirit and mouth speak in Jesus' name. I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to speak by the power and the utterance of the Holy Spirit of the Most High God right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I release it upon you right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, all power and praise be unto the Lord Jesus Christ right now in the name of Jesus. Amen, brothers and sisters. Just receive it. Just receive it. Keep praising and worshiping the Lord. And the Holy Spirit come upon you now in the name of Jesus. Just receive baptism of fire in the name of Jesus.